representatives in every state and senators want to spend every penny that's available to them. And in South Carolina and Tennessee and Virginia and a number of other states, they did that, and they were told that they had more money than they really were going to. In North Carolina, we ran into that 10 years ago when we had the dot-com bubble, and everybody said, oh, well, these revenues are going to continue forever, and then they fell off. And North Carolina was more aggressive than other states, and so we ended up in trouble earlier than other states. This time, I guess on the revenue side, we've learned our lesson and have made and they've done a very good job of keeping conservative revenue forecasts, conservative economic growth forecasts, and so that's been able to keep the legislators in line. Taking money, using it for one-time programs instead of saying, oh, we're going to have lots of money, and so let's build new programs, is also a good thing that they've done. So they get credit on both sides. The staff gets all the credit for the revenue side, and the legislators get some credit for saying, okay, we can't expect this money into the future, so let's use it on capital, or let's use it on something that we're not going to continue and build into the budget in future.